Hey guys, what's going on? So this is the second video for the voice leading for Autumn Leaves. I'm gonna go ahead and start right off. So since we already know what key we're in key G, starts on the 2 chord, that's A minor 7. Each of the voicings that I'm gonna do are on the same string set, 6, 4, and 3. So first chord, A minor 7. D7, with an A in the bass. G major 7. C major 7 with a G in the bass. F sharp minor 7 with a flat 5, but there's no flat 5. B7 with an F sharp in the bass. E minor 6 with a B in the bass. Here is an alternate set of changes for that first A section, A minor 7. D7. G major 7 with a D in the bass. C major 7. F sharp minor 7 with a C in the bass, or F sharp minor 7 flat 5 with a C in the bass. B7. E minor 6 with a B in the bass. So I'll do those two variations. Section. We'll start back with the F sharp minor 7 flat 5 right here. B7, we'll do a B7 flat 9. E minor 6. A minor 7 with an E in the bass. D7 with a flat 9. G7 with the D in the bass, C major 7, F sharp minor 7 flat 5 with flat 5 in the bass, C, B7 with a flat 9, that's the D sharp in the bass, and then the chromatic walk down from E minor 7, E minor 7, E flat 7, D minor 7, D flat 7, C major 7, B7, E minor 6. So the focus is, again, just the string set. This is not by any means all the voicings you could do. You could do a lot of different voicings. But I wanted to give you this set because this is a fairly basic set of voicings for these chords. And the thing to point out is that in each of the voicings, there are moments where there's no root note. For example, when it goes from A minor 7 to D7. The fifth is in the bass, the A is in the bass, the guide tones for the D7 are present, F sharp and C, but there's no root note, there's no D. For the C major 7, there's the fifth in the bass, there's the third and the 7, but there's no root note. There's a root note C. Oops. Same thing with the B7. Fifth is in the bass. Same thing with the E minor 6, the 5th is in the bass. Or just an E minor triad, the 5th is in the bass. Well, the root note is up here. But the root note is not necessarily in the bass. So you want to be paying attention to those chords where the root note is not present, make sure that you can see why the chord, why the voicing works, where the root note is in relation to the voicing. Because as we go on and change the voicings to more altered chords, or voicings where there's no root note, but there's, say, maybe more voices in the chord, it's going to be really important to be able to see the root note location so that you can understand why certain notes are called what they are, and why or how that voicing is found in relation to maybe a more common voicing. So like, if you know a D7 like this, but then you see that in this particular voice leading thing that we're doing, then hopefully you can recognize that the guide tones are here. We had a D on top and we had a D in the bass, but we eliminated both the root notes. We were left with just the guide tones, and then the fifth went in the bass. But you can hopefully still see the root notes. Oops. So that's where that becomes helpful, is seeing like bass movements, and then other times where the guide tones might stay the same, but maybe we'll alter other notes in the chord, like a flat 9. Flat 9, flat 13. So check that out. Hope that helps, and give a go at it. And I'll talk to you guys soon. See ya.